Hello and welcome back to the next Game Until I Die. This is episode 34 of my playthrough of Fallout New Vegas. In the previous episode, we talked to Mr. House in the Lucky 38 Casino, I think it's called. Now this casino has been locked up tight since the bombs fell 200 years ago, and nobody has ever been seen going in or out of it. So when we were invited in and talked to Mr. House and then left, the residents on the strip were very surprised to see anybody coming out of it. And we gained a bit of strip fame. We're a bit of a celebrity now. When talking to Mr. House, we found out that the platinum chip is something that he developed as the head of Robco back before the wars. He won't tell us what it does or what's on it. All he will let us know is that it's very valuable, and he wants us to recover it from Benny, who has apparently he was trying to groom to be his replacement or protege, but was betrayed by him, and wants us to take up where Benny left off. So we're going. Well, we did. We went to the tops and we snuck into Benny's workshop, where we found a Securitron that had been reprogrammed to basically give out any information requested of it and obey any orders given to it by anybody anywhere, which is not the greatest security model, but it works out well for us. The robot informed us that Benny has a plan to take over the entire Vegas area. And he thinks he needs the platinum chip in order to do this, but he isn't sure what's on it. He's asked Yes Man to examine the chip a few times, but they need some proprietary hardware in order to read the data on it. Now there's two places where this hardware can be. It could be in the Lucky 38 Casino, which nobody can get access to except for us. And I can't remember where it was, some fort somewhere I think. There's similar hardware that might be capable of reading the chip. So Yes Man suggests we go there and have a look around. We still haven't talked to Benny. I think we're going to start off by doing that and see what he has to say. Probably going to get a bit of a shock when he finds out we're still alive. And after that, I think we're just going to check our quest log and see what it is that we want to carry on doing. So yeah, I'm gonna load up the save. Alright, it seems like some of these elevators are inaccessible. I was quite lucky that the first one I checked was a working one.
Ah, the broads are better looking at Gamora.
Alright. There he is.
What in the goddamn? Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth moves, smooth. Hello. The guy everyone saw going the Lucky 38, that was you? Oh, shit. I hit what I was aiming for. Guess you had brains to spare. Or you just thick-skulled. Either way, baby, this is good news. Maybe I can finally sleep at night, knowing you didn't die. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere as more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer. To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed. If that's what it takes to win your trust, that's what it takes. Follow me. Don't get too close to Mr. Benny.
Mr. Benny.
I got my eye on you, so no funny business.
Well, he teleported someone.
Now that you and me's got some privacy, I gotta ask, how is it that you're still living? House was on to me from word go? I thought I was being so clever. Once you were vertical, how'd you track me down? To think I deemed that flint box my lucky charm. Oh, the irony. I guess that's enough scratching around at first base. Tell me, which way is the wind gonna blow?
In New Vegas, we know the pain that numbers can bring us. Well, so does Guy Mitchell, who's got heartaches by the number.
You've got a crazy drop on me here, baby, that's for sure. If killing's what you came for, this would be the time. But baby, you'd be disappointing me. All the trouble you went through to arrange this shindig must be something more you're after. You got questions, I got answers. It's the house edge, baby. Literally. It's what Mr. House needs to stack the odds in his favor. It's some kind of data storage device, Dig. So it's the data on the chip that's platinum, not the chip itself. Trouble is, the chip don't fit any computer I've found. Must require special hardware. It has something to do with the Securitrons, I know that much. Upgrades their hitting power, gives them heft. Might be slightly useful if you're looking to defend the Strip from Caesar's Legion or the NCR. Or maybe both. Baby, ease off the gas. The chip belongs in the hands of someone who can use it, as in me, not you. You'll get a piece of the action and a sweet one. But the chip sticks with me. You help me, and before long, the chairman will rule all of Vegas, Dig. With enough robot muscle to back it up, you'll get a sweet, juicy cut of that action. But until that day comes, I'll keep you on retainer and pay bonuses for special missions. How's that sound?
Special missions?
How else can I clue you in? Yeah, it's a tricky world out there. I'll tell it to you straight. A good cat to swing with, or was until he stopped mewing. It was House's big idea to resurrect the Strip. He recruited the three families as muscle, showed us how to set up casinos, negotiated with the NCR. None of this in person, mind you. Did all of his talking through those Securitrons of his. But lately, the silence is deafening. The robots collect House's share of the take every week, and life goes on. Ain't exactly what I'd call leadership. We're the definition of cool, baby. We know how to swing. Folks come to us to learn how to enjoy themselves. Of the three families, we're the only ones with the heart and savoir-faire to run the Strip on our own. A tribe of finks. Every single one of them is a degenerate. Mark my words, they're playing an angle. How do I know? They always are. Personally, they give me the heebie-jeebies. There's such a thing as being too polite. If I may this, my pleasure that. Don't get me wrong, that resort of theirs is strictly ring-a-ding. But my guts say, don't go in the basement. A nation of meddlers trying to muscle in on our action. Well, we got muscles too. And smarts besides.
Mr. New
only reason the NCR hasn't busted up our scene is they're a little afraid of Mr. House and a lot afraid of Caesar. If the NCR beats the Legion at Hoover Dam, they'll turn on us and claim the Strip. And we don't have the muscle to beat them. Not yet. Meanwhile, they're all that's keeping Caesar's Legion at bay. Plus, NCR soldiers and citizens are our best customers. It's complicated. Worst of the worst. A tribe of degenerate losers led by a creep. They crucify people for kicks, slaughter whole towns. The NCR beat them at the dam 3 years ago, but that didn't stop them. They spent the meanwhile gathering strength. They're gonna try to take the dam again real soon, and if they do, Vegas as we know it will cease to exist. Something else you wanted to know? Broad strokes, change in management. The Securitrons are where it's at. I need a way to control them and a way to beef up their hitting power. I get those two ducks in a row, Vegas can defend itself versus all comers. NCR, Caesar's Legion, it won't matter. You really weren't supposed to talk to him. All right. So, he used to be a Securitron on patrol, square as the rest, until I gave him a Mickey in the shape of a pulse grenade. Once he was on the nod, I yanked some wires and dragged him up to the workshop. I had some help, you see. Gal named Emily, one of the followers over in Freeside, a real whiz when it comes to things technical. She programmed his personality. Once Yes Man was hooked back into House's data network, I started learning a lot more about what he was up to, dig? Like where and when to find you. Baby, do you not understand the level of game here? What I did to you was rotten. But if you think House, the NCR, or Caesar won't kill to put Vegas in their pocket, I really did blow out your brains. It's a game, and games have winners and losers. I prefer the former. How about you? Baby, the odds may look long, but that's just because we ain't done rigging them. I won't toss the dice until we are. I've gleaned a lot working with Mr. House. He was a good cat to swing with. I still got a lot to learn, but it's coming together. Something else you wanted to know? Like I said, once the chairmen are running Vegas, you'll get a percentage. Until then, I'll pay you a retainer and bonuses for special missions. You forgive me? After what I done? Baby, are you trying to make me cry? I don't know what to say. Words don't begin. The least I can do is copy the presidential for as long as you want it. This spirit of forgiveness you're showing me, it's enough to make a player rethink what it means to win. You're 18 karat, baby, all the way.
Damn it.
Over here.
Oh. So, I have a feeling that we're going to be not very popular downstairs. Thank you.
Wonder where Benny got off to.
So apparently we're not. I was expecting lots and lots of minions trying to kill me, but...
Hey, you baby. What's the haps?
Apparently, they just...
Did you know the strip's all stirred up lately?
Welcome to the Tops. How can I help you?
Let's head up the stairs, I guess. Up the lift, rather. And see if we can confront Benny and get the chip. I'm pretty sure he just tried to kill me. Oh, apparently it's that way. I want my weapons back.
Hey, there's... Enjoying your stay? Relax, baby. The safe is houses.
Do I get roller back when I leave?
The eyes of the mighty Kaiser are upon you. He admires your accomplishments and bestows upon you the exceptional gift of his mark. Any crimes you may have perpetrated against the Legion are hereby forgiven. Kaiser will not extend this mercy a second time. My lord requires your presence at his camp at Fortification Hill. His mark will guarantee your safe conduct through our lands. Incidentally, it will interest you to know that the man you seek has fled the strip and is likely making haste for Kaiser's camp as we speak.
Okay.
Go to him, and you will understand. Seek Kaisar by way of Cottonwood Cove, south of Nelson. The Corsor Lucullus will be waiting.
Okay. So, Benny has run off to Caesar's Legion.
Hey, fellow, welcome. Smooth and easy. Oh, now the... Hey, there's the high roller.
Right, I want to go back upstairs now that we can just kill Benny's guards. Finish exploring his workshop. There were some rooms that we didn't check out. Sexy sleepwear. Elevator to a sub-basement. And a dead end. Well, let's go down to the sub-basement, I guess. What happened to Veronica? OK. Can't see any enemies down here. There's apparently something over here. Oh, that's Veronica. The hell is she doing over there? Why is my quest marker pointing at her? There's a whole lot of nothing down here. The key. Why am I losing calm for picking up? Never mind. I mean, it was red, so I knew it was owned by somebody else, but I don't think it would matter too much.
Say hello. I think he went down his secret escape elevator out in the hall.
Uh-huh.
Hope to see you soon.
I wonder if there's a key for it down here somewhere.
Ring a ding, baby.
So I'm guessing these are just random.
How's it hanging?
Hotel rooms. Interesting that we can pick half of them. Presumably without consequence, because they're not marked as red. Hey, Veronica. Oh well, let's go out into the courtyard. Let's finish having a look around here before we chase after Benny.
Ring a ding, baby.
How's it hanging?
What's up?
Doesn't quite work.
You dig this crazy scene or what?
Thank you. So it doesn't seem like there's actually... Oh, no, there is somebody to talk to.
Get you a drink? Best booze in Vegas, baby. What'll it be?
Don't really have that much. No. Well, let's head back out. What happened here? Was this always ripped to shreds? I don't remember it being like that. I'm gonna go through here and see Vault 23, was it? As well as the NCR diplomat. Vault 21, there we are.
Hey! Hi, I'm Sarah, Sarah Weintraub. Welcome to the finest vault hotel in the whole world. No, silly, of course it wasn't always a hotel. I grew up in it. I love it. My favorite place in the world. Not that I know much of the world. I never left this place, come to think of it. But it is the most special vault ever. My vault is pure New Vegas. Everyone has a chance, and Lady Luck smiles if you play your odds right. Okay, it was like that before we had to leave. Vault 21 had very smart ways to help people get along. All arguments and fights got solved through gambling. I'll give you a quick tour of my home. Oh yeah, if you like. Rightio, daddy-o. Let's do it. Alright, please follow me. We'll head into the vault right away. This bunker protects the entrance to the vault. Solid stone outside and thick steel on the inside.
You're gonna move. Thank you. It having to follow NPCs. I mean, technically, I don't need to do this at all, but I figured it might be interesting.
Above us, there's a control center for this level of the vault's life support systems, electric grid, radioactive shields, and all that jazz. Don't get lost. My vault has many corridors and rooms. Although it is no longer symmetrical, after Mr. House threw us out. This is the main game hall. Here we settle the big disputes among the vault's levels. Chosen representatives gambled against each other here. The winner earned the right to settle the dispute as wished by the collective. We used to have such parties in this diner. A bitch to clean later, but well worth it. Hello.
It's not much of a tour. You're just showing me rooms. You're not letting me go in. Gonna do stuff.
This hall leads to our guest rooms. You can use the first room on our left, but no snooping next door. That's my room. Always was. Down there is the game room. Each side of the vault had one, but the other is filled with concrete now. Okay, that wraps it up. I'll see you soon.
All right.
Good to see you again. All right, what would you like to know? No, silly, of course it was. Mr. House has everything to do with Vault 21. He tried to get us out before he filled it with concrete. I almost went ape. So we convinced him. Okay, Sheldon and I, right? We convinced him to leave the top level mostly intact. I don't know, maybe he didn't want anybody sneaking around down there. My vault runs deep and wide. It's filled with corridors and rooms that go far. What gives him the right to screw us with the Royal Shaft anyway? So he saved New Vegas. Woohoo! Now scram and let us go on with our lives. Sheesh. I see. Okay, your move. Yeah, and you gotta dig what I did with it. Looking as good as it should? Almost. It was bustling with activity. We all knew each other so well. You see, the vault kept us all even. It's all symmetry and windows down there. We solved any quarrels through gambling. Lady Luck cast no eyeballs, you know? So, nobody shafted anyone else. Yeah, I miss those days. Mitch? You mean Mole Butt? I hadn't thought about that name in a long time. I was just a child and he had a big mole in his rear bumper. You understand, kids and all that. Everyone knows about each other in a vault. There's no other way. I hope Mitch, is doing well. Sure, the place is packed. Usually. We get loads of NCR cubes these days. A stray Brahmin Baron once in a while, and recently circled couples shining big rocks on their fingers. Okay, how can I help you? I have all sorts of things. Vault souvenirs, vault wares, vault machines, vault mementos, and vault suits. And, well, lots of other vault things, too. Oh, yeah, sure. Okay, I got these great lunch boxes. They're super. What else? Oh, look at these toasters. You like toast, right? If they're crunchy, even better. What about a vintage Vault-Tec toy car? Or... Okay, I do, but who wants a lame sensor module or a nitrogen canister anyway? All the popular stuff has been sold, especially the vault suits. I need to find more because people buy them like hotcakes. Leather suits are good times. Thinking about that just blows my top. Really? Well, I don't even know what to say to that. Ha ha ha. Okay, why don't you help me out? And in the meantime, I'll think about where to take advantage of your skills. Oh, that makes me so happy. You are too much.
All right, I'm not entirely sure what I disagreed to do, but...
Good to see you again. Well, it is my vault, all right. That is, no. I take care of it, but I suppose you could say that it belongs to Mr. House.
Okay.
Okay, see you soon.
I think we've talked about everything worth talking about. This is definitely kind of mazy. There's a whole lot of people talking, but I can't see anybody.
Hello.
Hey, do you mind? I'm trying to drink myself to the ground right here. Scram.
That's food, not drink.
damn straight. This is about the last place in this fucking city where I can burrow without having to look over my shoulder. Who isn't in trouble in New Vegas, huh? Sooner or later, you hit the bottom of the barrel. I just happen to fall harder than most, is all. Yeah, I could have ended buried in the sands with just my head sticking out. Ants love that, a riot, know what I mean? This place has come a long way. Sarah takes care of it, and she lets me stay, for now. What doesn't she do, huh? Sarah makes this hole look like a palace. Damn nice pair of gams on her, too. She never walks outside, though. Because Mr. House ripped this place to shreds before filling it with concrete. Hey, I was untouchable once, but Mr. House is a god. You got that? I'm just one more loser that got the evil eye from Lady Luck. Hard fall. Now I lay at the bottom and keep to myself. From the top, where else, huh? I am Carlitos. My fingers work the magic and my hands deal the luck. There was no player who'd stood a chance, no wise guy who didn't fear me, and no doll who could resist me. Gamora was my kingdom, Carlitos' turf. Hey, you're smart. Okay, it was like finding diamonds in your vodka and showgirls under your card table. You want it, Gamora has it. It was heaven, until you find that all the glitter is made of broken dreams and all the praise hides a knife pointing at your ribs. Now, if you have to ask, you probably don't know shit about who you're dealing with, huh? Listen up. Watch out for Kachino. That's all I'm saying. It was heaven. I'd recommend you save your caps and your skin. Check the tops. No big-time wise guys there. Freeside's also fine, you know? There's too much shit and despair at Gamora already. I don't want anybody making it worse for Joe... for the girls, you know?
Uh-huh.
Okay, it's Joanna. She works at Gamora. But it's all my fault. I met her at the Atomic Wrangler. Beautiful doesn't even come close. I moved her into Gamora. I was in love, okay? Then Kachino, backstabbing snake, got me out of the way so that he could have my girl. He's a cunning bastard, Kachino. Told Nero and Big Sol he caught me spring cleaning my tributes to the family. Can't do nothing against that viper. What, you think I can just waltz in there and take her away? She's their doll now, okay? Besides, I step in Gamora and I'm as good as dead, you hear? You don't just leave the Emeritus unless it's in a body bag. Don't know. She's a dream to me now. If I could have her again, I'd be a made man. Why am I even scared of Kachino and all those fuckers? Joanna and I are dead anyway if we don't get the hell out of here. Okay. You try that and let me know. How she looks, what she's wearing, she's safe, anything. I'll pay you, you hear? Deal. Come back with news soon, you hear?
Okay. We've got another quest to do. Really is an awful lot down here, is there? Jet. I'm hoping we can get the tries reset. I'm pretty sure it's something that ends with E and then another letter. Still chosen. Did I try chosen? Hey, there we are. I guess it wasn't something that ended with E something. Vault 3 jumpsuit. 21 and 22. Didn't have any dresses, huh? Is it possibly to see sexy sleepwear? Thank you. Ew, the way down. Aha. So I wonder if the secret passageway in the tops actually leads to the lower levels of this fort. Who are you? Okay, I think we've just about explored everywhere down here. Am I just going around in circles here? I'm sure the way we came in was through here. Okay, let's follow the quest pointer, and that tells us which way we need to go. Nope. Aha. I think I found it. Yep, this looks good. I think we went through here though. Yeah, it just leads up here. See. Yes, that's the same.
I see. The food appealing, but say many I take care of it, but I suppose you could say that it belongs to Mr. House. Sure I have. I made the scene in the strip. It's just that I really like it here. Vault 21 is a kick.
I wonder if we can increase our perception temporarily.
Okay, see you soon.
That increases perception by one. And so does that.
Good to see you again. Okay, you're right. I hate going outside. It's almost impossible for me to step out of here. Still, I love my vault. It's my pad.
Get any experience for that?
All right, what would you like to know? Vault 21 had very smart ways to help people get along. Take a look at this.
Yeah, you've not really got anything worth buying either. Can't be bothered selling stuff just now.
Okay, see you soon.
Right, what quest are we actually doing? I mean, there's something there. That's possibly Mr. House, actually. Find some way of killing him. I don't know if we want to do that yet. Or at all, even. Well, you guys are so drunk.
Welcome to the NCR Embassy. How can I help you? Ambassador Crocker can be found in his office through the door to my right and at the end of the hall. The embassy offices are to your left, while the barracks and living quarters are to the right. If you're looking for a history lesson, I suggest you talk to Ambassador Crocker. I don't have time to give my life story to everyone that passes through. Is there something I can actually help you with?
Wow, nice.
Sir?
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for a nuclear winter.
I hear you've been meeting with Mr. House in the Lucky 38. I bet you think you're pretty special, don't you? Special or not, stay out of trouble, and more importantly, stay out of my way. Crocker isn't too bad. He mostly stays in his office now. If you have any questions about the embassy, you should ask him. He'll talk your ear off. Yeah, more the usual. We're keeping an eye on the troopers to make sure they don't do anything stupid. Yeah, the only stupid one we've had lately is Private Irwin. He's starting to cause more trouble than he's worth. Not much to tell. Keeping the troopers in line and monitoring the strip keeps me busy. It's my job, and I'm gonna do it well. Now, if that's all, I've got work to do. Bye.
She's nice.
Help you?
Right, everybody here is so very friendly.
Hello. What is it?
So you're the one that went into the Lucky 38. I bet that was pretty creepy. What can I do for you? Now, she may be a bit of a hard ass, but she's the best damn captain we've had here. I'd be careful around her. You don't want to get on our bad side. He's a little stiff and stuffy. Doesn't leave the office that much. Always surrounds himself with papers and reports. I've always wanted to play a prank on him, but there's no way I could ever pull that off without getting in trouble from Captain Pappas. Yeah, I got a few ideas that I'm working on. Maybe I'll let you in on it once I have something. What have you heard? I know people think I'm a little on the wild side, but I'm just trying to have fun, you know? Just because I happen to get into fights and like to pull pranks doesn't mean anything. Us troopers mostly come to the Strip for our R&R. We blow off some steam by gambling, drinking, partying, or fighting. If you're looking for a good time, I'd suggest hitting up Gamora. The girls there are pretty nice, if you know what I mean.
Sir? Help you?
Help me. So I think I went the wrong way. I think I went into the barracks rather than the embassy.
Hey.
A whole lot of letters lying around.
What is it?
Wow, nice big office.
I'm glad you could make it. I have something I wanted to discuss with you. It's a very important matter, and I have a strong feeling you're the perfect person for the job. I'm sure you've noticed that things are a little tense around here with all the issues between the NCR, the Legion, and Mr. House. It doesn't take a genius to see that something big is going to happen soon. To be honest with you, the NCR is in a tight spot. But if we fail now, it's the people here that are going to suffer the most. I'm not willing to let that happen. And I don't think you're the kind of person that would either. To the northeast is a settlement. The locals here call them boomers. They are sitting on a munition stockpile that would be invaluable to us. I would like you to get in contact with them, and then do whatever it takes to convince them to help us. Unfortunately, the boomers keep to themselves and are, let's say, hostile to all outsiders. That's why I need someone like you. Someone with your background and reputation would have a better chance of reaching them than anyone I have available. In exchange for your help, you would receive complete amnesty for any past crimes against the NCR, as well as additional benefits and perks. Do you think you would be able to do this for me? Much appreciated. Once you've talked to them, come back and let me know if they will help us.
The subtitles didn't match up there. But we needed to go to the boomer area to get the gun for Veronica, so... Yeah, more quests that get us to go there is a good thing.
Interested in politics, huh? Well, grab a seat and get comfortable. I've been in politics quite a while now. Always had the drive to do it even when I was young. It's just something I was drawn to. I started my career over 20 years ago, back in the NCR as the local mayor, and worked my way up from there. I managed President Kimball's first run for a seat on the council. I suppose that's why I have this ambassadorship. I was elected to this post 7 years ago. I'm the third NCR representative to serve here in Vegas. Now, I've had my share of ups and downs along the way, but I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. That's it. Anything else you wish to know? I can provide a quick history lesson, if that's what you're looking for. In 2274, President Kimball sent the NCR Army into the Mojave in force with the objective of occupying and repairing Hoover Dam. Rangers and Army scouts had confirmed that the dam was basically unoccupied and could be restored to an operable condition. Upon arriving at the dam, however, they discovered that a large force of tribals and robots had occupied it. This was our introduction to the three families, the Securitrons and, of course, Mr. House. Using his Securitrons as intermediaries, Mr. House called for parley. He claimed his forces had occupied Hoover Dam in order to safeguard it for our arrival, and that he was ready to turn it over to us, so long as we could agree to terms. Those terms became the Treaty of New Vegas. The treaty recognized Mr. House's sovereignty over the Strip and granted us rights to establish military bases at the dam and McCarran Airport. The NCR is legally permitted to send 95% of the electricity produced by the dam to our home states. The remaining 5% goes to the Strip. The treaty actually makes it illegal for the NCR to prevent its citizens or troops on furlough from visiting the Strip. Once on the Strip, our citizens are subject to arrest or punishment by House's Securitrons, though that's a rare occurrence. Our troops enjoy a different status. It's illegal for the Securitrons to take action against them. Of course, it's also illegal for our troops to carry firearms on the Strip, so there isn't much trouble they can get into. Our military police does an adequate job of keeping the troops on furlough in line. I don't envy them that task. The embassy was established a few weeks after the treaty was signed. Basically, Mr. House handed us a dumpy little building he had no interest in renovating. I'm the third ambassador to hold this post, and the first, I think, to accept its limitations. My predecessors had ambitions of engineering the annexation of the Mojave. They thought they'd convince Mr. House to join up. I've never even spoken to the man, or whatever he is. Maybe the situation will change once we've beaten the Legion once and for all. Now we mostly just keep track of the NCR citizens and troopers around and make sure they don't get in trouble, but that's Captain Papa's job. I keep myself busy with paperwork and reports that get sent back to the NCR. It's mostly busy work, but every once in a while we make progress. It's the same old stuff around here. Gambling, debauchery, drunkenness. It's all here. I'm getting a little old for it, however. If you want more information, try talking to some of the other guys around here. I don't get out of the office much anymore. Thanks for doing this. Remember, we need their resources to help us in the upcoming battle. Do whatever it takes. Goodbye.
Anyway, he seems like a nice enough man. Kind of curious about this though. So it seems like none of the ambassadors have had much luck here. This guy is the only one who accepts that he's not likely to get any.
Help you?
Oh well, that was an interesting wander around. Let's check what this is over here. That's possibly where Captain What's-Her-Name is. But yeah, I think we're going to leave the episode here for today. We're at the hour mark already. So, in this episode, we've confronted Benny and basically confirmed what we already knew. He has a plan to make himself the ruler of the Tops. No, not the Tops, the entire Tree of Vegas. And he needs a platinum chip in order to accomplish this. We said we forgave him for shooting us in the head, and then he sent his bodyguards in to murder us, so don't think we can trust this guy. He then fled and has apparently gone to the camp of Caesar's Legion. So we can follow him in our own time. After that, we had a little wander around Vault 21. Apparently it was a casino-based vault, which Mr. House filled in with concrete after they agreed to open the doors. Not an awful lot in there, so it wasn't as exciting as I was hoped. But we did discover that, well, I have a theory that the vault connected to the secret underground passage in the Tops. And also, I think it possibly connects to Lucky 38. I think Mr. House has some sort of living suite down there somewhere. Also, we can't gain access to a lot of the doors because they're locked with keys, so... Finally, we went to talk to the ambassador of the NCR, and he asked us to go talk to the boomers. We've already been to the boomer territory once and nearly got murdered by shells. So we're going to have to try and figure out a way of sneaking into there without getting murdered. Anyway, in the next episode, I'm not entirely sure what we're going to start by doing. Probably head to Gamora or the other casino that I've forgotten the name of, because we've got few quests to do around this area. I'm hoping that Edie will be ready for collection soon, and we can then head out into the wasteland again, and we can explore a few areas we've not been to yet. So, until then, thank you very much for watching, and goodbye for now. See you again soon.